Hallelujah. Good and blessed morning to each and every one of us. Are we blessed to be in the house of the Lord this morning? Amen. Hallelujah. Let us continue. Hallelujah. In this church, in this gathering, in this family that the Lord has given us, we bless the name of the Lord. Amen. And all that the Lord has given us, all the talents, all the skills, all the lives, all the souls, we use it to bless His holy name. Amen. Even Sep, the youngest, and to Mamshi Irene, the oldest. Welcome back. We are blessed to see you. And have you enlisted for the marathon yet? Is it ready for the marathon? It's not yet ready, eh? Hallelujah. We are very blessed to see you. We are very blessed, no? And to all of us who the Lord brought in this place, no? Ito yung mga sometimes, these are the blessings that sometimes we are thankful for the Lord of. Kasi, di ba, pag nasa Pilipinas ka, mga kapatid, if you are in the Philippines and you have a health, if you are in the Philippines and if you will need a hospitalization in any procedure, it's very hard. It's very difficult. So we are very blessed. Amen? So we are very blessed that the Lord brought us to this place, not just to bless us spiritually, but to bless us with the system. Amen po. Amen? Hallelujah. Sep, what time is it? What time it is? What time it is, mga kapatid? Tell your brothers and sisters, it is time to surrender to the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. Tell it to your brothers and sisters. It is time to surrender to the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Let us all surrender to the Holy Spirit. Let us be in His presence. Most gracious Lord and Heavenly Father, truly indeed that You are an awesome and amazing God. Truly indeed, Lord, that no one can fathom Your wonders, Your glory. No one can fathom Your extent, Father God. Lord, the fact that we know a little about You, the fact, Father God, that we have seen a glimpse of that glory, indeed us is a blessing. Indeed to us, Father God, is a remarkable privilege and opportunity. Father, we thank You that You have gathered us here today. Thank You that You have brought us all here today. Thank You, Father, that once again You are going to reveal additional part of You, that You are going to allow us to encounter and experience another part of Your nature. Most gracious Lord and Heavenly Father, once again, whatever are those that will hinder us in experiencing You today, whatever are those things, Lord, that can serve as a barrier, that can serve as an enmity, whatever, Father, those that serves as a stronghold in us, that we may fully grasp Your presence today. Lord, we humble ourselves down. Lord, we bow down. Father, we are willing. Search our heart. Search our mind. Search our innermost being. And if there are any places in there, O God, that we are yet to reconcile it to You, Father, let it be according to Your word, Lord. Thank You for Your cleansing. Thank You for Your forgiveness. Thank You that You have set us on that position, Father, to grasp You and to receive You fully today. Father, I pray that the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of quickening, the Spirit of fire, the Spirit of knowledge and understanding, be upon your people, including those who are tuning in online, including those that will come across this service at a later times. Father, minister to them. Lord, manifest yourself to them. Father, cause it, Lord, that even as we gather today, there is that life transformation, Father God, amongst all your people. Lord, hide me behind you. Cover my imperfection. Cover my weaknesses. Cover my physique. Cover my humanity. Cover my human nature, Father God. Hindi po ito, Lord, yung mensahe ngayong araw na to. Lord, I am just your mouthpiece. I am just your instrument. I am not even qualified, Father, according to the measures of this world. This is just an act of obedience to your call. And Lord, I pray that whatever words, Lord, that will come out of this mouth is truly touched, is blessed, and sanctified by you. We rebuke whatever works and wiles in the schemes of the enemy that will try to hinder us in receiving you fully today. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Once again po, good and blessed morning. And it is my prayer, my dear brothers and sisters, that the Holy Spirit will reveal Himself to us today. Amen. Sino po? It's very unusual. Punong-puno yung side na to. Dito sa side na to ay mga empty chairs. Hello po, Nay. Welcome. Oh. My dear brothers and sisters, let us carry that burden. Ipagdasal po natin itong mga chairs na to. Pagdasal po natin itong mga vacant chairs na to in order for the Lord to fill them up. Amen. The Lord is the Lord of the harvest. Manggagawa lang po tayo, mga kapatid. Hindi po tayo yung magbibigay ng paglago, kundi ang Panginoon. Amen. And it is in our best interest na ilagay natin ang Panginoon sa ating side. Once again, Tainay, welcome. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, I pray for the Holy Spirit to reveal Himself to us and in order for us to fully grasp the revelation of the Holy Spirit, I pray na magkaroon po tayo ng that heart, that desire to surrender to the Holy Spirit this morning. Amen. I know, my dear brothers and sisters, that this is not the first time that we have heard the message. This is not the first time that we have heard from people, that we have heard from preachers, that we have heard from ministers encouraging us, telling us, preaching to us to surrender to the Holy Spirit. Amen? This is not the first time. Amen? And this is very true because we now know that the Holy Spirit is God Himself. Amen? The Holy Spirit is the third person in that triune head God. Our God the Father, our God the Son, Jesus Christ, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen, church? But the question now, the message now that I want us to grasp today, that do we actually know how to surrender to the Holy Spirit? Or tinuruan po ba tayo nung nagsabi sa atin, nag-exhort sa atin na you must surrender to the Holy Spirit? Tinuruan po ba tayo, were we actually taught how to surrender to the Holy Spirit? And that is my prayer and that is the will of the Lord and aim of the Lord for us today to teach us and to equip us one or two on how to surrender to the Holy Spirit. Are you ready, church? Amen. Amen. In Ephesians chapter 5, verses 15 to 18, it says in here, my dear brothers and sisters, be very careful
Chef, be careful in drinking that milk. Yeah, marami. Be very careful, my dear brothers and sisters, when you associate the word be very careful, what does it mean? It's a warning. Di po ba? When you're eating, be very careful. You might choke. When you are driving, be very careful. You might met an accident. So when you say be very careful, my dear brothers and sisters, it is associated with a warning. And why someone says be very careful? Because that someone cares. Amen. So you are sitting right here today. You are tuning with us here today with the encouragement that the Lord cares for you. No one came here by their own desire. No one came here by their own accord and will. You are here today because the Lord cares for you. And the Lord says, be very careful. Amen. Be very careful then how you live. Not as unwise, but wise, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. Do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Amen. Debauchery meaning, mga kapatid, corruption. Corruption ng ating sarili siguro, maybe the corruption of our mind, maybe the corruption of our spirit, maybe the corruption of our faith. Debauchery meaning our sinfulness. Amen. Man's wickedness. So that is the warning of the Lord. Instead, be filled with the Spirit. Amen. So the Lord says, I care for you. Be very careful. Why do you need to be careful, my dear brothers and sisters? Because it says in here that the days are evil. Amen. Mag-ingat po tayo dahil ang mga araw ay masama. These last days, my dear brothers and sisters, the days are evil. Why is it evil? Because Satan ruled this world. Satan ruled this world. Satan is the prince of this world. Amen, my dear brothers and sisters. That's the reason why Jesus says, or the Lord says, I care for you, be very careful. Amen? Because the days are evil. Because the days are evil, the Lord says, you need to be wise. You don't want to be unwise. You don't want to be foolish. Amen. What is foolishness, my dear brothers and sisters, in this passage? Foolishness is, you know that it is a wrong thing, and yet you still do it. Amen. You know that going there is bad, still you go there. Amen. You know that doing one thing is bad, but still you do it. Foolishness. Committing a suicide is foolishness. You know that when you commit a suicide, you will end up dead. And when you are dead by committing a sin, which is suicide, you know that you will not be accepted in the kingdom of God. Hindi ka naman pwedeng humingi ng kapatawaran bago ka gumawa ng isang kasalanan. The principle of the Bible is gumawa ka muna ng kasalanan bago ka humingi ng tawad. Amen po. So those people that will say that, Lord, forgive me for what I am about to do, hindi po po pwede yun. Amen. Hindi mo naman pwedeng ihingi ang isang bagay na hindi mo ipinagkasala. So that's what the Lord is saying. The days are evil, therefore be careful. Don't be foolish. Amen. What is the will of the Father in this passage? The will of the Father or the command of the Father in this passage is for you to be careful. For you to live wisely. And sa paanong paraan? How can we live wisely? How can be very careful in this passage? The Lord says, do not get drunk with wine. Amen. That is the command. Do not get drunk with wine. The emphasis of the command, instead, be filled with the Spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise you, Jesus. So my dear brothers and sisters, we reconcile that the Lord care for us. Amen. And we now know that the days are evil. And we now know that it is in our best intention in Pusikton not to live as foolish. Meaning not to live as unwise, but we need to live as wise. And living as wise meaning do not get drunk on wine, but be filled with the Spirit. Amen. So if I ask the question, if we ask the question based on this passage, that are we obeying the command of the Lord not to get drunk on wine? I'm sure na yung sagot, maski hindi kayo sasagot, resounding yes. Amen. I know that that's resounding yes na, yes, we do not drink wine anymore. Because we are believers. We are Christians, natutunan natin, especially in Sion. Especially in Sion, especially to those people who come and stand here in front. Yan po yung isa sa mga bagay na we do not mix up. Isa yung mga bagay na we do not want to enter into a gray area with. Malinaw po natin yan, nilatag natin yan na malinaw na malinaw. Amen. So if to ask that question na, do we still get drunk with wine? Umiinom pa ba tayo? And the answer is resounding no. Because I am a Christian. Because I am a believer. Because this is the temple of the Holy Spirit. I'm not gonna defile it. Amen, mga kapatid? Yun po ba ang sagot natin? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise you, Jesus. Well, that's the easy part. Yun po yung madaling parte, mga kapatid. That's the easy part. But how about the second part of the command? Be filled with the Holy Spirit. Amen. Are we being filled with the Holy Spirit? Do we desire to be filled by that Holy Spirit? Hindi lang po one-off, ah. When we say, be filled with the Holy Spirit, continuous po yan. Amen. So, how about the second part of the command? Yes, we are excelling on not getting drunk on wine. What about the emphasis of the command that be filled with the Holy Spirit, mga kapatid? Are we in obedience of that command? Are we obeying that command, mga kapatid? Is that the life that we are living? Amen? If for some instance, no is the answer, the question there is, why not? Because as a Christian, as a believer, andyan po na we can only operate if we are filled by the Holy Spirit daily. Just like a car, our fuel, our oil is the Holy Spirit. Yan po yung natutunan natin last Friday. Amen, church. Mga kapatid, yung the word that is used in here, they are quite synonymous. Amen. To be drunk, meaning mga kapatid, to be filled. Ano po ba yung isang ginagawa ng isang tao if they are getting drunk? They keep on filling themselves with alcohol. Amen. So getting drunk, mga kapatid, it's synonymous to being filled as well. Amen. So getting drunk or being filled with alcohol, what happens to us? What happens to a person if you are getting drunk or if you fill yourself with alcohol? Mga kapatid, kung titignan nyo ito, it is not the act that bring you into sinning. It is the fruits of getting drunk. Being filled or getting drunk, my dear brothers and sisters, what happens to us? We put ourselves under the control of alcohol. Amen. We surrender our sanity, we surrender our mind, we surrender everything in us, our body, our spirit, our soul, to the influence of the alcohol. And if we do that, mga kapatid, that leads to debauchery, corruption, wickedness, sinfulness, mga kapatid. But in the contrary, if we are being filled with the Holy Spirit, kabaliktaran naman nun, mga kapatid. We are putting ourselves, our body, our mind, our spirit under the control of the Spirit of God. Amen. We voluntarily submit and surrender our everything to the Spirit of God. And when we do that, what happens to us, my dear brothers and sisters? When we surrender, when we let ourselves filled by the Spirit of God, what happens to us? We tend to live in the will of God. Amen. We tend to live in the will of God, sa kalooban ng Panginoon. In the will of God, in this message, my dear brothers and sisters, is for you and me and all the believers to be filled with the Holy Spirit. Amen? Be filled with the Holy Spirit. So my dear brothers and sisters, there are few key points in here that the Lord gave on how to surrender to the Holy Spirit. How can we surrender to the Holy Spirit, my dear brothers and sisters? Number one, we can surrender to the Holy Spirit through the Word of God. Sa pamamagitan po ng salita ng Panginoon. And if you are here last week, our message was that the Word of God is no other than Jesus Christ. In the Word of God that we are reading, which is called the Bible or the Scripture, is the written Word of God. Amen. Whereby Jesus is the spoken Word of God, the Bible, the Scripture, is the written Word of God. So when we talk about the Bible, we talk about the Scriptures, the write-ups that pertains to Jesus Christ, to the life of Jesus Christ. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, in order for us to be filled by the Holy Spirit, we need to dwell in the Word of God. We need to dwell in Jesus Christ. John chapter 7 verses 38 to 39, it says in here, whoever believes in me, Jesus said, rivers of flowing water will flow from within them. This river of living water, he meant the Holy Spirit, with whom those believers will receive when they dwell to Jesus Christ. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, in order for us to be filled with the Holy Spirit, we need to dwell in the Word. We need to dwell in Jesus Christ. Kailangan manahan po tayo sa Panginoong Hesukristo. Amen. The Holy Spirit is not something na nakukuha sa dasal. The Holy Spirit is not something na nakukuha sa pag-iyak. The Holy Spirit is not something that you can gain by buying or purchasing. The Holy Spirit can only come to you the moment that you surrender your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Malinaw po. The moment that you surrender your life to the Lord Jesus, the moment that you submit your life to the Lord Jesus, the moment that you accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, then that is the only moment that you will have the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, there are thousands or probably even millions of spirits. But there is only one Holy Spirit. So if you believe that you have the Spirit in you, and yet you have not yet fully surrendered your life to the Lord, wake up. Wake up. My dear brothers and sisters, be warned, my dear brothers and sisters. The Holy Spirit is our seal of guarantee that we are a children of God. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, when you go to the shop and you buy an item, and that item is big, fridge, freezer, bed. They will not hand that bed to you. They will not hand that fridge, freezer to you. What they will hand to you, the receipt that you have paid, the receipt that you own that fridge and freezer, and that fridge and freezer will be delivered in your home in a matter of days. The same thing that when you receive the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, although you are saved now, but the materialization will be in the end, at the time of the Lord. But in order for that guarantee, the receipt of the Holy Spirit is given to us. Amen, church? Isaiah 66:2, the Lord says, has not my hand made all these things? The Lord is talking about His creation. The heavens, the earth, and everything that is in it. And the Lord said, has not my hand made all these things? And so they came into being, declares the Lord. These are the ones that I look on with favor. Pay attention. Them are the ones that I look on with favor, thus saith God. Those who are humble and contrite in the spirit, those who tremble at my word. Amen. Who is that word again? Jesus. The moment that you dwell in the Holy Spirit, the moment that you receive the Lord Jesus Christ, the moment that the Word of God resides in you, my dear brothers and sisters, the Lord says, honor it by trembling on it. Tremble, not because, you know, that holy fear na tinatawag. You do not tremble because of terror. Some children, they tremble at their parents because of terror. But most children tremble of their parents because of that holy respect. That respect. Amen. So the same with the Lord, my dear brothers and sisters, that in order for us to be filled and surrender to the Holy Spirit, we need to tremble at His word. We need to have that holy fear at His word. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, if you want to surrender to the Holy Spirit, the first and foremost, we must know, we must admit, we must accept that word, which is no other than Jesus Christ. Amen. We must cherish Him. We must reverence Him. We must obey Him. Because my dear brothers and sisters, you cannot obey an instruction without first receiving it. Amen? You cannot obey a command without first being given. Amen, my dear brothers and sisters. We cannot yield, we cannot submit to a command if we did not knew that command. So my dear brothers and sisters, sabi niya rito, we need to know that word. We need to know Jesus, and we need to know everything that is written about Jesus. Romans 10:4, it says in here, how can they call on the one they have not believed in? How can they believe in the one they have not heard? Amen. How can you call on someone nga naman if you do not believe in the Lord? How can you believe in the Lord if you have not heard Him? And how can they hear without someone preaching to them? Papaano natin maririnig ang tinig ng Panginoon kung hindi tayo makikinig ng kanyang mga salita, kung hindi tayo magbabasa ng kanyang salita, kung hindi tayo bibili ng Biblia, kung hindi tayo magda-download ng Bible application? How can we hear, how can we read without first putting ourselves into that position? Coming to church is one of them. When you are at home, opening your Bible is one of them. When you listen to Bible study is one of them, my dear brothers and sisters. So in order for us to be in a position to be filled, to surrender, my dear brothers and sisters, we need to know that word. We need to be accustomed with that word. Amen. Hallelujah. And when we have that word, mga kapatid, when we obtain the word of God, kung naumpisahan natin, once we receive that word of God, what is that song that we always sing? We ask the Lord for a pure heart. A pure heart, that's what I long for. A heart that follows hard after thee. A heart that hides your word so that soul may not come in. A heart that is undivided to him who rules and reigns. Amen. Mga kapatid, if you value one thing, you need to make sure that you protect it. Amen. Your hard-earned money, your hard-earned cash, you value them. And because you value them, what do? To them? You put them in the bank. You invest them. Amen. Your tuxedo, your coat and tie, you value them. What do? You buy probably a special covering to them and you keep them nicely in your cupboard. Amen. If you value the word of God, if you value Jesus whom you receive, the author of your salvation, where are you going to keep him? In that pure heart. Amen. In that pure heart. So that no one can steal. No one can take away. Amen. The problem, my dear brothers and sisters, is not by unwillingness to receive the Lord. The problem is not because we did not receive the Lord. To be honest, I believe that each and every one of us have actually desired and received the Lord. The problem is, where do we keep the Lord? Where do we keep the Lord? Do we keep the Lord in that pure heart? The word of the Lord says, be very careful to work out your salvation with fear and trembling. Amen. Hallelujah. Number two, the first is, we need to know the word, or we need to know Jesus. We need to dwell in the word. We need to dwell on Jesus. Number two, my dear brothers and sisters, is we need to be mindful of His presence. Amen? We need to be mindful of that presence. Where is the presence of God? Who is the presence of God? The Holy Spirit. Galatians 2:20, the moment that we accept the Lord Jesus as our personal Lord and Savior, it says in there, it is no longer I that live, but Christ lives in me. The Spirit of Christ lives in me. Amen? By the way, the Holy Spirit is called the Spirit of God or the Spirit of Christ. They are both the same. Amen. So if the Holy Spirit is in you. The Holy Spirit dwells in you. Be mindful of His presence. Amen, church? 1 Corinthians 6:19, do you not know that you, your bodies, are the temples of the Holy Spirit? What does temple means in the Old Testament? The dwelling of the Lord. That is where you see the Lord. That is where the Lord dwells. That is the dwelling of God. But this time, my dear brothers and sisters, the dwelling of God, the temple of the Lord, is no longer in Jerusalem. Do you know where it is? Look at your brother and sisters. Look at them. Face them. That is where the dwelling of the Lord is. You are the temple of the Holy Spirit. You are the dwelling of God. Amen. Amen. The Holy Spirit dwells in you, whom you receive when you receive God Jesus Christ. Amen. You are not your own anymore. Amen. Amen. Tell your brother, you are not your own anymore. You are not your own anymore. The Spirit of God dwells in you, and the Spirit of God is in you. Amen, church? Siguro nandun yung Spirit of God. Ha? Siguro nandun yung Spirit of God. Ano? Hallelujah. Ano kailangan ko rin pumunta dun? Be mindful of His presence. Be mindful of His presence. We are learning, church. You know, this is very important. Ano? I just want to check ko lang yung kwan kanina. Being mindful of His presence says that you long for that presence. We long, ano yung, hindi ko kaya yung tono ni Che. We long for that presence. You bow in His presence. You linger and dwell in His presence. Amen. We seek that presence. Kung napansin mo na nawala ka sa presence, hanapin mo, you seek that presence. That's what the song says earlier. Amen. And that is the rema of the word. That song preached the word this morning. The presence of God. And the presence of God is in you and around you. Amen, church. This is the game changer. This is very important. You know, if you are aware of His presence, this is very important. For example, sino po ang manggagawa rito? Lahat po tayo manggagawa. Amen. We are all workers. We are all employees. Amen, church. Bear in mind, keep in mind, a worker who is at work and the boss is there. Wow, that worker all of a sudden became hard worker. Di ba? Naging masipag. Amen. Hindi niya alam yung definition ng katamaran. Amen. A child who their parents are there, aba naman, napakabuting anak. Amen. Aba naman, napakabuting anak. But when the parents are not there, makikita mo how do they behave. And this is the game changer. If we are mindful of the presence of that Holy Spirit. Amen. If before you talk, you consider that, hang on, the Holy Spirit is here. Before you think, hang on, the Holy Spirit is here. Before you do something, hang on, the Holy Spirit is here. Kaya nga mga kapatid, this is really the game changer. Because if you realize Yeah, bakit tayo nakakagawa ng mga bagay? How do we do things? Why are we able to do things? Why are we able to say and think of things? Because simply because we think that we can get away with it. Because simply we think that it has no damage. Because it simply we think that wala naman akong kasama, mag-isa ko lang. My dear brothers and sisters, be aware of His presence. Amen? You are not your own. Even if you hide yourself inside the drum, you are not your own. The Holy Spirit is there. Amen? You are not alone. It is not all about us. We cannot just do what we want. We cannot just say what we want to say. We need to consider the presence of the Holy Spirit. We need to consider the mind, the thought, and the heart of the Holy Spirit. Amen? And take note that Holy Spirit is in you 24/7. Hindi ka niyan papahingaan. Hindi ka niyan lalayuan. Hindi ka niyan aalisan. Amen, church? Hallelujah. Once you come to realize the presence of the Holy Spirit, katulad ng isang empleyado, sabi ko nga, mababago ang pamamaraan ng pamumuhay natin. Amen. Once we are mindful of the presence of the Holy Spirit, my dear brothers and sisters, we will begin to walk in a whole different way. We will begin to talk in a whole different way. We will begin to think in a whole different way. We will begin to live our life in a whole different way. Amen, church? Why don't we claim and believe that the Holy Spirit is in me? Amen? Is the Holy Spirit with you? Why don't you not claim it? The Holy Spirit is with me. The Holy Spirit is in me. Amen. He is aware of what I am doing. He knows of what I am thinking. He can hear what I am saying. Kaya this is the game changer, my dear brothers and sisters, because if you become aware of His presence, you begin to fellowship with Him. Amen. If you are aware with His presence, you begin to fellowship with Him. You begin to communicate with Him. You begin to talk with Him. Amen, church? Pansinin nyo, experiment, Tainay. Maghapon, magkasama kayo, no? During the week, yung mga bata pupunta sa school, si Karen tsaka si Abby nasa trabaho. Kayong dalawa lang. Subukan mo, Tay, na walang dahilan, wag mo lang kausapin si nanay maghapon. Nung sasabihin ni nanay, mag-iisip, magtataka, magtatampo. Kasi magkasama na nga kayo, hindi mo kinikibo, hindi mo kinakausap. The same way with the Holy Spirit. Nandyan na yan, and yet you are not going to speak with the Holy Spirit, and yet you are not going to fellowship with the Holy Spirit, and yet you are not going to commune with the Holy Spirit. Mas busy ka pang makipag-usap sa iba. Mas busy ka pang gumawa ng ibang bagay. That's what we call idols. If everything that we do and anything that we do, take the space in the time of the Lord in our life. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, if we are mindful and if we are aware of this, the presence of the Holy Spirit in our life, mababago po yung ating buhay. And for me personally, I know and I do believe that that is the most important moment in my life. When I have that fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Well, with argument's sake, bakit hindi ba importante na kasama mo yung pamilya mo? Ba importante na kasama mo yung asawa mo at mga anak mo? Ay, syempre, mas importante kung kaming magkakapamilya ay we are fellowshipping in the Holy Spirit. Amen? Hindi ba mas importante pag kasama nyo ang church? Ay, of course, mas importante kung kasama namin ang church. Kung yung buong church is dwelling in the fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Amen? We cannot take the presence of the Holy Spirit out of the equation. Amen? yung sinasabi nyong ini-enjoy nyo, yung sinasabi nyong masaya kayo, I doubt. Try to involve and include the Holy Spirit in those activity. And makikita nyo how it will transform everything. Amen, church? Hallelujah. Number three, live in repentance. Amen. Ano po yung number one? Dwelling in the Word, which is Jesus and in His written Word. Number two, my dear brothers and sisters, we are mindful of the presence of the Holy Spirit. Number three, mga kapatid, let us live in repentance. Mamuhay po tayo, mga kapatid, sa paraang nagpapakumbaba tayo sa Panginoon. 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all forms of unrighteousness. Sister Grace prophesied as well earlier that even says that, even I, for my name's sake, I will not just forgive your sins, I am willing to blot out your sins. Amen. The difference of your sin being forgiven, your sin is there, but the Lord refused to acknowledge it. Your sin is forgiven, meaning nagkasala ka. But because the Lord has forgiven you, the Lord refused to see it. The Lord refused to consider it. Babayaan mo na yan, baliwala yan. But once the Lord has blot out your sin, mga kapatid, ibig sabihin, parang hindi ka nagkasala. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, hindi po natin nakikita, aarok yung glory, yung mercy and grace of the Lord. And it's not late to begin right now. Come in desire to the Lord that, Lord, I just do not want and desire your forgiveness. Father, I desire that you blot out my iniquities. Sa Ate Grace, sabi mo, Satan, we rebuke you. We rebuke our past. We rebuke of who we are. My dear brothers and sisters, ask more than the forgiveness of sins. Ask the Lord to blot out your sin. Because you know, if your sins are forgiven, the Lord refused to acknowledge that, the Lord refused to see that, the Lord refused to consider that, but who does not refuse? The Satan, the enemy. Satan will always bring your sin to you. Even the Lord has forgiven it, Satan will always say, ah, ito, 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 ito. But once you ask the Lord to blot out your sin, burahin yung iyong kasalanan, not even Satan can come. Dahil wala na siyang iaakusa. Malinis ang record mo. Amen. Walang bahid ng pagbubura ng lapis. So desire your sin to be blotted out. Live in repentance, mga kapatid. Amen. If we confess our sin, He is faithful and just to forgive you your sins. And sabi niya doon, you cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Amen po. And I want us to understand this. Pay attention to here, mga kapatid. Why do we sin? Bakit po tayo nagkakasala? We sin because we give in to temptations. Amen. We sin because we give in to temptations. Sin is not just like a default or instant event. Sin, mga kapatid, may contribution ang kalaban. May contribution ang Satan dyan. Sin is because we give in to that temptation. Amen. And that temptation, my dear brothers and sisters, is being bred in our mind. Sin is being bred in our mind. Diyan po siya, mga kapatid, nagbubrew. It is in your mind that it will be brewed. It will bread, mga kapatid. And if it was not checked, that temptation will give birth to sin in our heart. Amen. Sin will enter our mind using different stimulus. Kaya nga mga kapatid, even in science, every stimulus will be processed in our mind. Amen. Isang apoy na mainit, hinawakan mo, mga kapatid, bakit mo tatanggaling mapaso? Because your brain says it so, mainit, tanggalin mo. Amen. Subukan mo yung mga tao na may problema sa brain nila. Bakit kaya hawak na nila yung apoy, naglalagablab yung kamay nila, hindi nila matanggal? Because their brain is not interpreting it. It's pretty much the same thing. Every stimulus that the enemy is using, our eyes pag may nakita tayo, our ears pag may narinig tayo, sometimes even yung nose, pag may naamoy tayo, di ba? Our emotion, our soul, pag may naramdaman tayo, diretso dyan, goes straight to the mind. And it brews in the mind. That temptation brews in the mind, my dear brothers and sisters. And if we did not check it, here comes the day that it will give birth to sin in our heart. Nakakagawa tayo ng action na hindi dapat. Amen. That is the reason why that before it is being born as a sin in our heart, while it's still being processed in the mind, that's why live in repentance. Living in repentance, it does not mean, my dear brothers and sisters, na humingi ka ng kapatawaran every Sunday sa lahat ng accumulated sin. That's not what it meant. Living in repentance, my dear brothers and sisters, is constantly. Constantly. Amen. Amen po. Hallelujah. Romans 12:2, do not conform to the pattern of this world. The pattern of this world, my dear brothers and sisters, is to entertain temptation. The pattern of this world says that malakas ako, regardless na I entertain temptation anyway, kaya kong kontrolin, hindi ako magkakasala, but that's not the pattern of this world. The pattern of this world, my dear brothers and sisters, is for our mind to be transformed, for our mind to be renewed. Amen. Every time that the stimulus comes, live in repentance. Lord, renew my mind. Lord, cleanse my mind. Purge my mind. Lord, ayoko itong nararamdaman ko. Lord, ayoko itong bumabagabag sa akin. Amen. Hallelujah, my dear brothers and sisters. Our mind needs to be renewed constantly. Our mind needs to be released. Our mind needs to be let go. Amen. Yung mga bagay na hindi makakaglorify sa Panginoon. Yung mga bagay, mga kapatid, that is not God-honoring. My dear brothers and sisters, di ba, in your messages, in your email, in your computer, those things that are not helpful, beneficial, those things, spam. You delete them. You take them away. Otherwise, your email will end up with hundreds of thousands of messages. Amen, church. The mind needs to be renewed constantly by how? Living a life of repentance. Living a habit of repentance. Amen. Every time that temptation lands in there. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, let us live a life of repentance every time a temptation comes. Huwag nating hintayin na makagawa tayo ng isang bagay na hindi kaaya-aya sa Panginoon. Huwag nating hintayin that it will be birthed in our heart as sin. Amen, church? Before those sinful habits begin, subdue it and offer it to the Lord. Amen. Before those corrupted words are gonna be uttered, subdue it and offer it to the Lord. Amen. Before those lustful thoughts begins to develop in your mind, subdue it and offer it to the Lord. Amen, church. Before certain relationship that you know you should not be entering, evolve, subdue it and offer it to the Lord. Amen po. Before we think, before we act, before we talk in a certain way that defiles your faith, that defiles your body. At the end of the day, my dear brothers and sisters, it is your body that is going to be defiled. It is not others. It is your body that is going to be defiled. It is your body that is going to be suffer. It is your body that is going to be tainted and marked with iniquity. Ayaw nating humarap sa Panginoon na burdado ang ating katawan. My dear brothers and sisters, it is for your sake. Amen. So again, wag po nating i-ignore ang mga temptation. Anything that the enemy is using to come and dwell in our mind, wag po natin silang i-ignore. Maski gaano kang kalakas na Kristiyano, you cannot delay it. Sometimes, pag malakas tayong Kristiyano, okay lang, I'll stand around and see what happens. Ay pagpasabukas ko na lang. Hindi, mga kapatid, please don't. Let us not ignore those temptations. Let us not ignore everything that the enemy is brewing in our mind. Live in life of repentance. Amen. Because by living a life of repentance, we are renewing our mind. We are not conforming to the pattern of this world any longer. Amen, church. Number four, act in faith. Amen. Lahat ng bagay na to, all of these things, my dear brothers and sisters, if we act in faith, it will not work. And faith, it says in there, our perfect definition, faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the evidences of things not seen. Amen. So my dear brothers and sisters, faith is very important. Faith is the area of our life that we all need to grow. Faith is the area of our life that we all need to learn, mga kapatid. We all need to learn to take a step of faith. Sometimes, the world says, assurance, safety. My dear brothers and sisters, if you're gonna wait for assurance and safety, you will not receive miracle. You will not receive miracle. Miracle is birth when you act in faith. Amen, church. Hallelujah. Amen. Before God will move in your life, before God will move in your circumstances, you know what? God will require you to do something that you are uncomfortable with. Before the Lord will move in your life, I challenge you, yung isang bagay, that one thing that you have been so desiring, that one thing that you feel so elusive, tell the Lord, Lord, prepare me and I am willing. Father God, let me do one thing that I am uncomfortable with. My dear brothers and sisters, in order for God to work supernaturally in your life, God will let you do strange things. Example, I know a man whom the Lord promised, I will make you the father of many nations. You will be the father of many nations. Even at your 90 years old, your wife is ano na yun? The womb of your wife is close, barren, but I will make you the father of many nations. His name is Abraham. Amen. And the Lord gave him a son, who is called Isaac. And the Lord asked him, you know what, Abraham? I want you to sacrifice Isaac for me. In your eyes and in the eyes of Abraham, Lord, have you forgotten your promise? Lord, have you changed your mind? You promised me to be the father of many nations. You only gave me one son. And now you are asking it back. It's counterintuitive. It does not make sense, Panginoon. It is outside the concept of expectation. Paano ako magkakaroon ng dalawa? Eh kung yung isa nga, kukunin mo. Paano, how can I be a father of many nations if the only one son that I have, you are taking it away from me? It does not make sense, Lord. But what Abraham do? Act of faith. Lord, I do not understand. This is your promise to me, and this is what you want me to do. Lord, I do not understand. But Father, I'm not going to rely on my own understanding. I'm going to trust in faith to you. And history happens. History begins. You and me are sitting in here. You and me are praising and worshiping the Lord in here. We won't be here. We won't be doing all these things without the faith of Abraham. Amen. Abraham is the father of many nations, and Abraham is the father of all who have faith. And the last time that I checked, that is you and me. Amen, church. Amen. Hallelujah. Before God will work with you, God will demand uncomfortable things. God will ask strange things from you. Before God will move on your situations, He will ask something na hindi mo naiintindihan. But that's the reason why act of faith. Because kung naiintindihan mo, mga kapatid, if everything that you are doing is you understand, if everything that you are doing is comfortable, if everything that you are doing is within the concept of norms, mga kapatid, I'm sorry to say, you are not acting of faith. But the Lord demands faith. The Lord demands for us to do something that we do not understand. The Lord demands something that sometimes it seems strange, mga kapatid. Amen. Sister Grace stood here and exhort about tithes. Do you actually know what tithes means? Lord, ang purpose ko ay mag-ipon. Tumawaw. Lord, ang purpose ko ay mag-ipon. Ang purpose ko ay punuin si Barclays, si Lloyds, dahil yun naman yung pangako mo sa akin, that all the good gifts comes from you. Pero paano ko naman mapupuno yun, Panginoon, kung every ano, kukunin mo yung tithes ko sa'yo? Kabaliktaran yata, Panginoon, ah. Paano ko naman mapupuno kung hindi ko lahat ilalagay doon? Kung gusto mo, bawasan ko. Don't forget, Lord, ha? Gumagamit ako ng gasolina pag pupunta ako sa church. Don't forget, Lord, lahat ng binibigay kong pag-bless sa mga kapatid. Oh, put that into the cheshbon. What's the cheshbon? Hebrew, cheshbon. Put that into the bill. Ilagay mo yan sa resibo. But mga kapatid, act of faith. You can never outgive God. You can never outgive God. You know, if you are earning 1,000, it's very easy to give tithes. that if you win 184 million, wow, wow, if you win 184 millions, you are to give that 18.4 million to the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's continue. Oh, that's just joke lang po yung last part nun. Ha. We are not exhorting. We are not... Hallelujah. Church, I encourage you and I know and I do believe, I exhort you that the Lord is about to do something great in you. The Lord wants to get involved in your situation. The Lord wants to get involved in your circumstances. The Lord wants to manifest Himself in you. Not in only in you, but including your household. Your faith, your walk, your relationship with the Lord, your ministry, your family, your work, your community. Yung pinaka-desire natin, the Lord is willing to get involved. The Lord is willing to visit those areas of your life. Amen. But just be ready. Just be ready. Especially when the Lord leads you to a place that doesn't seem comfortable. The Lord will lead you to an action that are counterintuitive. It does not make sense. And I pray and I cry to the Lord that as the Lord will fulfill that each and individually with you. I do not have, Lord, spare me. I do not have any personal desire para sa akin and for these people. What I desire is for this church. I pray that the Lord will get involved. I pray that the Lord will revisit this church, will revisit His people. And sometimes, there are things that it does not make sense. There are things even that kung titignan mo, it seems negative. There are things even that parang it does not build up. But my dear brothers and sisters, let us not rely in our own understanding. A Christian does not rely on their own understanding. A Christian does not act in what is obvious. Let us jump if we need to jump as an act of faith. Let us sit down if we need to sit down as an act of faith. Amen, church. Hallelujah. Pag pinag-uusapan po natin, if we talk about surrendering to the Holy Spirit, we must understand, my dear brothers and sisters, that it is not just an outward expression. You know, when you say that, I surrender to the Holy Spirit, it is more than just outward expression. It is more than just claiming and declaring so that you can hear audibly, so that people can see visually na, oy, he or she is surrendering to the Holy Spirit dahil kliniklaim niya. When we talk about surrendering in the Holy Spirit, hindi lang po yung para ka dyan feeling subdued, yung para ka dyan na tahimik na, para ka dyan na hindi makabasag ng pinggan. And others will say, wow, He is being filled with the Holy Spirit. He is being surrendered with the Holy Spirit. Or it's more than na tumatalon tayo, more than na we are on fire, my dear brothers and sisters, in order for others to say na, wow, He is filled with the Holy Spirit. He is surrendered to the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters, being filled or surrendering in the Spirit is more than a prayer, more than devotion in His Word, more than attending a church or a fellowship, more than attending a Bible study, more than the praise and worship, no? More than when you close your eyes and you raise your hands and even you cry during the praise and worship, my dear brothers and sisters. It is more than when we sing in there or when we sing in here. It is more than when we stand up and minister, my dear brothers and sisters. It is more than when we participate in a given activity or task. Surrender to the Holy Spirit, my dear brothers and sisters, demands that radical obedience. Yung obedience natin sa Panginoon. Radical obedience says, it does not make sense to me, but because you say so, not my will, but your will be done, Lord. Amen. Amen. When you give your life to that uncompromising commitment, it is very easy to commit to the Lord if we have so much to give. It is very easy to commit to the Lord if we are kagagaling natin sa day off and malakas na malakas tayo. It is very easy to commit to the Lord if we are healthy and well. But the true level of commitment can be measured kung yung wala ka nang ibibigay and yet gusto mong magbigay sa Panginoon. I must not compromise. I must focus, sabi niya dun. I must keep my life pure. Amen, church. And just i-recap po natin. I must dwell in His Word. I must know His Word. I must know Him. I must be mindful of His presence. I must live in repentance. I must act in faith. Amen. And I must desire and pay attention to what the Lord is about to tell me, to show me, to manifest on me and in His people today. Let's bring back the music team, mga kapatid, and let us receive from the Lord. Let the Lord magnify Himself among us. Kung hindi natin natutunan, kung hindi natin naintindihan yung mensahe, mga kapatid, brother, sister, mga anak, tatay, nanay, let us connect to the Holy Spirit and say that, Holy Spirit, I did not understand that message. Can you reveal it directly in my heart? Can you minister directly in my heart? Can you talk to me directly in my heart? Let us stand up, church. Let us be in the presence of the Lord. And I know, and I do believe, that the Lord wants to fill you today. The Lord wants to fill you today. And before He is able to do that, mga kapatid, let us surrender. You know, just like in a battle, just like in a war, when you surrender to the opposing party, what do? We lay down everything. You lay down everything. You show your white flag and you lay down everything. You lay your arms, you lay your weapon, and submit and surrender and yield. My dear brothers and sisters, the Lord wants to fill you today. The Lord wants to fill His church today. But first,
we need to raise that white flag and say, Lord, I surrender. Lord, I lay down all the barriers. Lord, I lay down all the sins. Lord, I lay down all the strongholds that will hinder me, that will stop me, that will promote me going out of this church today without being changed. My dear brothers and sisters, surrender to the Lord. Raise those flag. Sayang naman if the Lord is going to fill your neighbor and He cannot fill you because you are not surrendered. Live an act of faith. Live an act of faith. If you are in need of healing, if you are in need of deliverance, if you are in need of refreshing, if you are in need of feeling, and the Lord is pushing you to come and stand in front, you can say that, oh, it's an act of faith. I can stay in here. I can stay in my place and pray and desire. The Lord can work with me. Yes, I agree. But if the Lord is leading you to come here in front, your position does not change. But what changed is the demand of faith. And sometimes, faith makes a big difference by just that few, 2 or 3 steps. Cover those spaces. Cover those steps. If the Lord is leading you to come here in front, then bring yourself in front. Music team, the Lord's been preparing you for the whole week. The Lord's been dwelling in you and through you the whole week. Let us serve the Lord with joy and excitement. This is not your work. This is not our work. But in hope, desire that, Lord, fill these people today. We trust in you, Lord. Fill these people today. Fill the heart of your people today. Fill the life of these people today. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Here in your presence, oh Lord, we seek your face.
Come on, church, it's more than a song.
Here in your presence,
it is a desire.
Lord,
it is a declaration.
Let's
say, Lord, I'm lifting up my flag.
Here in your presence, oh Lord, we seek your heart.
Lord, I don't want to withhold.
We long for your presence.
Church, let the Lord fill you.
We love your presence.
Let the Lord fill His people.
So we linger and dwell.
Here in your presence.
Here in your presence, oh Lord, we seek your face. Here in your for your
church, receive the presence of the Lord.
Here in your presence, oh Lord, we seek your face.
Come on, people of God.
Here in your presence, oh Lord, we seek your heart.
We welcome.
We welcome your presence. Treasure your presence.
Come on, fan into flames.
We love your presence, so we linger and dwell.
Fan into flames those gifts.
Here in your presence,
fan
oh
into flames
Lord,
those talent and skills.
We seek your face.
Fan into flames what the Lord has given you.
Here in your presence, oh Lord, we seek your heart.
We welcome.
We welcome your presence. We treasure your presence. We love your presence. So we
presence,
we
Lord.
Love your presence.
I want to
so
be in your presence, oh God. Visit me
again,
in this place, right here, right now.
Here in your presence.
Visit me in this place,
Lord,
right here, right now, Lord.
Seek your face.
I want to stand face to face.
Here in your presence.
I want to encounter you.
For your presence,
let your church
be bowed in your presence.
We love your presence.
We love your presence. So we linger and dwell.
Once again, here in your presence.
Here in your presence, oh Lord, we seek your face.
here in the place.
Your presence, oh
those giftings, those talents,
we
those
seek
skills,
your heart.
Those calling that the Lord has called you upon.
We long for your presence.
Spirit, fan into flames.
We bow in your
stand
presence.
Up for the Lord and for his people. Feel our sister Gracie here, Father God. Fill her with your presence.
We seek your face.
Fill her with your power. Exceedingly.
Here in your presence, oh Lord.
For your name's sake.
We seek your heart.
For your name's sake. Lord,
we long for
let the laying of these hands, Father God, bring fullness and fulfillment of your plans, of your desire, of your calling upon earth through your Son Jesus Christ. Fan into flames. Fan into flames. Hallelujah.
So we linger in.
Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah.
Here in your
praise you, Jesus.
So Lord, we seek your face. Here in your presence, oh Lord, we seek your heart.
Lay hands mo nga sila sa likod. Both of them. Both of them.
We love your presence. So we linger and dwell.
Your presence,
Lord. Here in
your presence, Father.
Oh Lord,
your presence, Father God. Changes everything.
Here in your presence,
in your presence Lord,
oh Lord,
it brings refreshing.
We seek your heart.
It brings joy. It brings fullness. It completion, Father God. Holy Spirit, you are the fire of God. Holy Spirit, you are the fire of God. And although, Father, in the life of a believer, as we serve, as we worship you, as we honor you, as we come in your presence, even as we work, Father, even as we tend to the needs of our household, to the needs of our children, Lord, it is given, it is expected, that fire in us will be extinguished. Lord, you are aware that we are just mere human. You are aware that we are just a mere flesh. And human and flesh as we are, Father, napapagod kami. Father, napanghihinaan kami. Father, nauubusan din kami. And although one day we are on fire, and the next day, Father, we feel distant and cold, you put all those into consideration. That is the reason why our dear brother Lester, our dear sister Alma. The Lord understands, and the word of the Lord says in Leviticus chapter 6, the Lord says, hallelujah. The word of the Lord says in Leviticus chapter 6, beginning verse 12, the fire on that altar must be kept burning. It must not go out. Every morning the priest is to add firewood and arrange the burnt offering and fire and burn the pot of the fellowship offering and eat. The fire must be kept burning on the altar continuously. It must not go out. That altar symbolizes our life, your life. That symbolizes you. That altar symbolizes you. And the offering on top of the altar symbolizes everything that you do. Everything that you do for the Lord. Everything that you do for each other. Everything that you do at work. Everything that you do for your children. And that priest signifies you. Kayo yung priest that is offering an offering to that altar. And in order for that offering to reach the Lord, in order for that offering to be consumed na masunog, you need that fire. You need that fire of the Lord. And that fire is the Holy Spirit. That fire is the Holy Spirit that the Lord gave us. And like what we've said, in every given situation, it is understandable that the fire extinguish, the fire dwindle, lahat ng apoy nang hihina. Pag nababasa, pag nauubusan ng fuel, ng panggatong, nang hihina. It is for that reason that the Lord command us to fix those firewood. Ayusin yung mga panggatong. It is the Lord's command that that fire must not go out. That fire must not stop. That fire in you must not stop. The fire of the Holy Spirit in you must not go out. And the command of the Lord is, every morning, you have to put a firewood. And that firewood represents our prayer. That firewood represents the word of the Lord. That firewood represents fellowship in the Lord. Father, thank you. Most importantly, Father, sa buhay ng aming mga kapatid, kapamilya, Brother Lester, Sister Alma, thank you very much for today, for giving that message to them. That you understand that there is that expectation for that fire to cool down. But thank you for the provision, Father, on how to keep that fire burning. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord, Brother Lester, Sister Alma. That fire in you must keep burning. That fire in you must keep on burning. Lord, I stand here today, including my sisters, my sister Annie standing at her back, laying the hands, Father. Let that laying of the hands impart that fire, Lord. Lord, I myself personally, I can see the fire on Sister Annie. And let that fire, Lord, be imparted upon your servant, Brother Lister, Sister Alma. Let the fire, Lord, from your servant be imparted upon this couple. Let the fire, O God, be imparted upon their life. Put a firewood every morning, Brother Lister, Sister Alma. that prayer, that devotion, that feeling and submitting to the Lord. That means, Lord, being filled by you and submitting to you means that I will constantly dwell in your word, in your Son Jesus Christ. That means that I will be aware of His presence. That means that I will live a life of constant repentance. I will take a step of faith. Oh, Rabashikia Fire from heaven. Come and rest upon my brother. Come and rest upon my brother here, O God. The way that tongues of fire rest upon the believers during the time of the Pentecost. Come and rest upon his life. Come and rest upon the life of Sister Alma, Father God.
Galak at sa pag-asa, ang nais ko
kanta dyan sa puso natin, napakaganda.
Ang nais ko'y purihin ka, Jesus. Ang nais ko'y purihin kang lubos.
Yes, Lord, yung undivided love, Panginoon.
Sa bagyo at sa problema.
That undivided love, Lord.
Sa galak at sa pag-asa.
That love that is not influenced by things that I see. That love that is not influenced by my past experience. Lalong-lalo na yung mga experience where I was betrayed. Yung pagmamahal, Panginoon, na hindi nakabase sa kung ano yung naiisip ko, nararamdaman ko.
Yung
pagmamahal, Lord, na hindi nababase kung ano yung nakikita ko sa ibang tao, kung ano yung reaction ng ibang tao. Yung pagmamahal sa'yo, Father God. Yung desire, Panginoon, na hindi nakadepende kay brother, hindi nakadepende kay sister, na hindi nabrabrant ni brother, hindi nabrabrant ni sister. Lord, yun po, Lord, yung karapatan mo, Father God, yung mamahal kita ng ganong level, di po ba? Yun po yung deserve ko, Panginoon, di po ba?
That even
in the spite of my pain, even that in spite of confusion, even in spite, Panginoon, na sometimes may mga bagay na kung hindi maisurrender, hindi makalimutan, hindi ma-give up. Pero Lord, hindi po yung magiging hadlang, di po ba? Gusto kong ibagay sa iyo, Lord, yung nararapat sa iyo, Panginoon. Yung nararapat sa iyo, Panginoon, di po ba? Yung mapuri kita. Not because of my limitation. Not because of my experience. Not because of my pain. Lord, tinataas ko sa iyo ang iyong anak, ang aming kapatid,
problema,
si Cherry,
sa galak at
tinawag
sa
mo bilang iyong anak,
nais
bilang iyong ministro, Lord,
Jesus,
bilang worship leader ng iglesyang ito,
nais
bilang isang may bahay kay Kenneth,
ibigin ka, Jesus,
bilang nanay kay Zephaniah, bilang kapatid sa aming lahat, ang anak sa kanyang mga magulang, sa Pineda, sa mga Perez, maski sa mga spiritual family. Father, alam mo kung ano yung puso ng iyong anak. Alam mo, Father, kung ano yung kalooban ng iyong anak. Kaya, Father God, I pray that it is not about her. It's not about yung mga balakid. It's not about kung hindi niya kayang ibigay. It's not about kung ano yung kanyang pagkukulang. It's not about, Lord, sa isang tao. It's not about sa isang grupo. Panginoon, itulot mo na mahalin ka niya ng buong buo. Lord, a lot of eyes are upon her. Your eyes, lalo na the eyes of this church, the eyes of the brethren, the eyes of her family. And sometimes, Father, sa dami ng bagay na yan, nakakapagod, nakakapagal, nakakabigat sa mga balikat, Panginoon. Especially, Panginoon, pagdarating yung time that it is against our will as well. But Lord, I pray for this daughter in faith, Father, that fire must not go out, Jerry. That fire must not extinguish sa lahat ng kapaguran, sa lahat ng mga dasal na hindi pa dumarating, sa lahat ng sakit, sa lahat ng mga experiences, yung mga bagay na para sa'yo, pero hindi dumarating o hindi ipinagkaloob. Yung mga bagay na para sa'yo, Lord, dapat napanghahawakan ko na yan. Pero bakit hindi pa dumarating? Let that fire continue to burn. Let that fire will not extinguish. It is not within your ability to give or withhold. It is the Lord's ability to receive you. It is not what you give or what you do. It is the Lord's ability to consider you. And the Lord consider you a very long time ago. And today, right here, right now, in this pulpit, Cherry, the Lord has considered you. The Lord has reconsidered you once again. Cherry, let that fire continue to burn. Let the spirit of refreshing come once again. Let the spirit of joy, let the spirit of security, let the spirit of stability, let the spirit, Lord, of love in fullness be upon Cherry, Father. Walang kakulangan, Lord. Walang kakulangan. Ano man yung mga pag-aagam-agam, ano man yung mga takot, Lord, ano man yung hindi maisurrender, maigive up sa'yo, right here, right now, Lord, reassure your daughter Cherry. Reassure your daughter Cherry and say that, my daughter, I am in control. I am in control. I am in a position to receive that sacrifice in offering. What I want from you is do not let that fire go away. Do not let that fire burn away. Do not let that fire dwindle. I have accepted you and I am accepting you. Declare the Lord. Be secured. Be confident. Be filled with the Lord. Wala kang kulang. Wala kang kakulangan. You are perfect. And the Lord put you in that shoes. Just who you are. Just how you be. The Lord gave you a history. The Lord gave you a past. The Lord gave you a learning. The Lord gave you a message in the past to bring you in this situation. To bring you in this position. The Lord brought you in this church because He has willed and He has planned for you. The Lord gave you to Kenneth. The Lord gave you to Zephaniah. The Lord gave you to everyone just who you are. You are perfect in the eyes of the Lord. You do not have to change one thing. All you need to do is continue to let that fire burning. Continue to let that fire burning. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. All you need to do now ay mahalin ang Panginoon sa pamamaraang word siya. Mahalin ang Panginoon, ibuhos ang pagmamahal sa Panginoon sa paraang karapat dapat siya. Amen. Amen. Come on, church! Church, this is the time. Tagalog yun. Nais ko. This is the time, church, na ibalik natin sa Panginoon yung pagmamahal. Nakarapat dapat siya. Kung hindi ko maiibigay yung pagmamahal sa Panginoon ngayon na hindi siya karapat dapat, then might as well I won't. Kung hindi ko maibibigay sa Panginoon yung buong-buong pagmamahal sa Kanya ngayong araw na to, then might as well I won't. Dahil alam ko sa aking puso, alam ko sa aking buhay na isang klaseng pagmamahal lang ang dapat-dapat sa Panginoon.
Ibigin kang lupo.
And that is yung buong-buong pagmamahal.
Higit sa lahat ng bagay.
Yung buong-buong pagmamahal.
Higit sa aking buhay.
Mahalin natin ang Panginoon ng buong-buong church.
Ibigin ka, Jesus.
Sabihin natin, kung hindi natin kayang ibigay, kaya nga sabi niya doon sa kanta, Lord, ang nais ko, ito ang nais ko, Panginoon, na mamahal ka sa paraang karapat-dapat ka, Panginoon. Kung sa mga nakaraan, Lord, I withhold. Kung sa mga nakaraan, Father God, hindi ko na ibigay ang buo sa'yo. Ngayon, Panginoon, right here, right now, ang nais ko, Panginoon, ay mahalin ka ng buo. As the music team continues to sing, the people of God, I want you to stop singing except the music ministers, people of God, people who are tuning in online, I want you to stop singing.
Sa bagyo at sa problema, sa galak at sa
and I want you to surrender everything to the Lord. All eyes are closed now. All eyes are closed now. Establish that connection with the Holy Spirit that is in you. I urge you to lift your hands as a sign of surrender to the Lord. Stop singing. Stop talking to the Lord. This time, just let the Lord talk to you. Let the Lord talk to you. Let the Lord reveal something to you.
Ibigin ka, Jesus.
Gustong makialam ng Panginoon sa buhay mo. Gustong makialam ng Panginoon sa sitwasyon mo. Meron siyang i-reveal sa'yo. Meron siyang gustong sabihin sa'yo. Sige, for 2 minutes, let us be still. Let us close our eyes. Let us bow our heads and let us raise our hands and listen to the Lord. For 2 minutes, music team, continues.
Ang nais ko'y ibigin ka, Jesus. Ang nais ko'y ibigin kang lupon. Higit pa sa lahat ng bagay. Higit pa sa lahat ng bagay,
higit pa sa aking buhay, ang nais ko'y ibigin ka, Jesus.
Hallelujah. For the last time, let this be our prayer. Ang nais ko. And when we say nais, di ba nais is buong puso po yan. When we say nais, Lord, this is my desire. Ito po yung gusto ng aking kalooban. Ito yung gusto ng aking puso. Let that be the prayer in declaration of our life and a spirit that is within us this morning. Sige mga kapatid.
Ang nais ko'y purihin ka, Jesus. Ang nais ko'y purihin kang lubos. Sa bagyo at sa problema, sa galak at sa pag-asa, ang nais ko'y purihin ka, Jesus. Ang nais ko'y ibigin ka, Jesus. Ang nais ko'y ibigin kang lubos. Higit pa sa lahat ng bagay, higit pa sa aking Jesus. Higit pa sa lahat ng bagay, higit pa sa aking buhay, ang nais ko'y ibigin ka, Jesus. Higit pa sa lahat ng bagay, higit pa sa aking buhay, ang nais ko'y ibigin ka, Jesus. Ang nais ko'y ibigin ka, Jesus. Ang nais ko'y ibigin ka, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Lord, our desire is to love you with all our heart, with all our mind, with all our soul, with all our strength, with all our understanding, with all our resources. Mga kapatid, once again, Leviticus 6:12, it says it there, that fire must continue to burn. That fire must not go out. So my dear brothers and sisters, yung nais natin sa ating puso na mahalin ng Panginoon, na sambahin at purihin ng Panginoon, yung nais na yan manatili. Hindi mawawala sa puso natin, mga kapatid. Hilingin natin sa Panginoon that, Lord, itong nais na to na inilagay mo sa buhay ko, sa puso ko, itong nais na to na mahalin ka, purihin at sambahin ka sa paraan, O God, na karapat-dapat ka, ay hindi mawala, hindi maalis, Father. Irregardless of whatever challenges, trials, problems, tribulations, difficulty that will come, Lord, that desire is intact and remain in my life. This is my prayer in Jesus' name. Hallelujah! Praise you, Jesus! Bigyan po natin, let us give the Lord the clap offering that He deserved. Hallelujah, Lord!
Praise you, Jesus!